going on, Wavers? It's Nick with a new video. Before I get started, let me give you guys an update on what my waves are looking like. To let you know, my information is valid. You know what people say, man. People talk a whole lot of shit on YouTube, man. People call me Mexican and shit. Anyways, the video I'm gonna do right now is how to get 360 waves. I've never done a beginning video like this, so I'm gonna go through the process of what you need to do when you want to get started. Where do you start? How do you continue? Where do you stop? First, you're gonna need some products. What you're gonna need is a moisturizer. I use Beautiful Textures Moisture Butter. I used to use Olive Cream, but I felt like that caused too much frizz in my hair because it was a water-based product. So I shifted over to Beautiful Textures Moisture Butter, and it works well for me. You need to moisturize your hair. You need to moisturize your hair most likely every day, because when your hair is dry and brittle, when you brush it, it's not gonna lay down. It's just gonna frizz up. When your hair is soft, just brush it. It's gonna be much easier to train, much easier to lay down. So, a moisturizer besides the brush and the durag, you need all three: moisturizer, brush, durag. I use Beautiful Textures. Next, when my hair is long and I'm wolfing and I need something to hold it down, I use Roller Coaster Waves. It holds my hair down. It has a crazy smell. Make sure you check out the commercial I did for that. Hopefully, it's on the side. And when my hair is short and I want some shine and I want it to be soft, I'm putting in that premium Wave and Scalp Butter. I love the smell of this one. It smells like coconut. All natural. You could use it all day. Now, to get 360 waves, your hair needs to be curly of some sort, because waves are flattened out curls. Just think of a curl, and when you lay it down, that'll be the S. That's where you get all these S's from. Now, when I say curls, I mean something like this. This is me wolfing maybe 3 weeks. My hair is curly, as you can see. When it's short, it is not curly. That's why I continue brushing until it gets to this stage, and then I can get my waves. Next, before we get into this, the haircuts you need to get. If you have all your hair, cut it all off right now. When you go to the barber, ask him for a 1.5 with the grain or a 2 with the grain. Depending on your hair texture, it all varies on if your hair is nappy, if your hair is straight, soft, etc., etc. I personally get 2s with the grain. I can get a 1.5 and my waves will be popping. You guys have seen the picture of it, most likely. But I don't do that anymore, because 2 days later when I brush it, I wash it, my waves go away, because my hair is not curly at that short length. I've been getting 2s lately with the lever turned up. That's the perfect length for me. I want to go a little shorter, but we'll see what happens. Next up, the most important piece to getting waves is the brush, the bristles. The bristles lay down your curls. When you lay down the curls, they turn into the S's, and there's your waves, like so. I have a premium from Crown Quality Products. It's a soft and a medium mixed together. And I also have my soft brush, which lays down my hair. It's the finisher, you know, it's just the final piece of the puzzle. To brush your hair, when you first start, I want you to get in the mirror, the hand mirror, you need one of these. And I want you to find your crown. Your crown is where your hair starts to part away. My crown is right here, so I want you to comb it. I want you to comb it according to where you're going to be brushing. You'll thank me later. Trust me. So comb this out. Comb out your crown according to how you will brush your waves. And before you start whining about the crown, just remember the crown is the most important part to wave, and it's the hardest part. So when your crown is combed out, you're gonna get your brush. You're gonna look for the top of the crown. Depending on how you want your waves to go, you're gonna start from here, brush all the way down. Start from the crown and brush all the way down. The reason why I say brush all the way down to the edge, think of it like this: you're swimming in the ocean. You got your surfboard, your body surfing, you're ready to catch this wave. It's coming huge and it just dies. That's a useless wave because you didn't get to ride it. If the wave rolled all the way into shore, you would have had your surfing done. That's why it is very important to brush all the way to the edge. You don't want waves stopping up here or here. You want them all the way here. That's how you know you're serious. So start from the crown, brush all the way down. Just remember that. Start from the crown, brush all the way down. I might make a song for you guys so you guys can always remember it. Brush it all the way down. The sides, start at the crown, all the way down. Right here, this is how I brush my hair. Everyone's hair will be different. All the way down. Top here, all the way down. Side here, all the way down. Right here, start from the crown, all the way down. So my glasses are blocking. I don't brush my glasses, but I can't really see with all of them right now. All the way down. So you're gonna do, I'm telling you to do maybe 2,000 to 5,000 strokes. So I'm saying 1, 2, 3, 5,000 times minimum. I brush my hair at least 5,000 times a day. Real talk. That's how you get healthy hair too, man. So the girls love it. So I'll do it, man. Next, you're gonna need to, when you're done brushing with the medium, your hair is going to be frizzy, but it's going to be deep. You're going to grab your soft brush, and you're just going to brush it. What the soft brush does is finishes out your hair. It adds a nice shine to it, and it works on your connections because it doesn't go all the way to the scalp. The soft brush just glazes over the top of the hair, and that's how you work on your connections because you're brushing the waves, not the scalp. And you're done with that. Put your do-rag on. So there's two ways you could do your, you could tie your do-rag. Once you've done all your brushing, put it on your head. You could either tie it back and then tie like a knot. But what I like to do now, I just found my wave cap. But you can see the rips in it. This is old. It's probably like 2 years old, maybe even three. What you're gonna do is put it over it, over your waist. What the heck? Like so. The reason why I like putting the wave cap over my do-rag is because the wave cap can cover the hair all around the edge of the ear. When you have it tied behind, it may not necessarily lay down. It might start to frizz up, especially when you move around and stuff. When you sleep like this, the wave cap edges are tight and it won't move that much. So a recap of what you need. First, you need curly hair. Then you need to cut your hair 1.5 or 2 with the two with the grain. You need to get a moisturizer or some sort of wave cream, roller coaster waves, for example. A brush, a comb, do-rag, wave cap, and a mirror. Also, above all of this, you need dedication. What you put in is what you get out. If you put in work on your 360 waves, you'll see it. You'll be like, yo, I'm spinning for real, and you'll get compliments and everything, man. If you don't, if you're just brushing like 1, 2, 3, that's it, and say, oh, I can't get waves, yeah, you won't get waves, man. But yeah, make sure you subscribe, check out my other videos, all sorts of videos, all sorts of methods, all sorts of product reviews, check it out. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, comment, that's all.